Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to do a matte everyday look. I'm going to be using a lot of neutral colors, and if you love this look, please continue to watch and make sure you like and subscribe. Love ya.
Using my NARS oil-free primer, I'm going to apply that over my face. Next, using my Morphe foundation palette, I'm going to apply that with my primer oil. And my MAC Pro brush, I will use that to apply the foundation. Next, using a beauty blender, I'm just gonna blend that in. Next, using my Naked Urban Decay palette, I'm going to be using a round brush in the color just on my arch of my eye. Using my Naked palette again, I'll be using the second color on the Naked palette. Next, using my Smashbox, I'm going to apply a dark brown just to the corner of my eye. Next, using my LA Girl Pro Concealer in the color Cool Tan, I'm going to highlight my entire face. Next, using my Stay Matte by Maybelline, I'm going to apply this under my eyes and in the same spots I use the concealer highlighter. Next, using my Mario Badescu setting spray, I'm just going to apply that to my face to blend all my colors in together. Next, using my Morphe palette, I'm going to apply this to my contour areas. This will give my face definition. Next, just using a blending brush, blend in all of my makeup together. Watching from the sideline. Next, using an angled small brush in my Morphe palette, I'm going to contour my nose. This is the main thing for me with my makeup looks. I love contouring my nose. There's already a huge difference just with that contour line. And then I'm going to go in and blend that together. Next, using the beauty blender I used for my highlighter, I'm just going to go in and highlight the inner of my nose, which I want to stay light. Next, using my box of mascara, I'm going to go in and apply mascara prior to me adding my false lashes. I love to use many coats of mascara. It enhances the look. Knock on my door when my stars is a lino. I've been fishing for a minute, for a minnow. Only I know that a pawn is a trade and a rookie for a castle like this. And always apply mascara to your bottom lash. Winds on my window. Ash on my skin when the record low temps for the wind blow. Only right rhythm to the tardiest of tempos. Next, using drugstore eyelashes, I'm just going to apply that using my dark tone eyelash glue. Tell us where the hell is all the paper. And tweezers, of course. All the nights that we used to laugh. Wanna know how I used to watch, how I used to watch. Memories keep playing back. All the nights we used to love. Just wanna how I used to watch. How I used to watch. Memories keep playing back. All the nights we used to love. Just wanna how I used to watch. How I used to watch. Next, using my box of mascara, I'm going to apply that, mixing my natural lashes and my false lashes together. And of course, I have to hit my bottom lashes. Oops. Now going in with my Becca highlighter using Champagne Pop. I'm going to apply that to my cheekbones, my nose, and my lips, and the Cupid's bow. Now using a different beauty blending brush, I'm just going to mix all of that makeup in together. A circular motion or a swiping up motion. Next, using a drugstore lip pencil. This may even be an eyebrow pencil. You can use an eyebrow pencil. I'm just going to go in and outline my lips for this 90s inspired lip look. And this is just a dark brown color. This is my go-to lip look if I'm doing something simple, but I want my lips to be the main attraction. I'll use a dark lip liner. And then I'm going to blend that in a little. And using my MAC brush, I'm just going to clean up the edges. Blend, blend, blend. Then I'm going to add some chapstick. That helps to blend the colors with my natural lips and the lip liner together. You can already see how it's fading out. That's exactly how I want it to look. Fix the errors. Now going in just with the drugstore lip gloss, I'm going to apply that on top. This completes the look and that's exactly how I want it. Very 90s.
Hey
hope you guys love this look. Make sure you like and subscribe. And just a note, my mom is officially certified in lash extensions. So if you would like your lashes done, hit her up at 810-252-5578. And that would make this look even more natural because all you have to do is add mascara if you would like. And you don't even have to because lash extensions look so dark and vibrant. So you don't even need mascara unless you want to. And as you guys can see, I'm having brown hairs coming through because my natural hair color is sandy brown. Most of you don't know that because I haven't shown that color since I was 16 and younger. However, I'm thinking about adding blonde to my hair next. So comment what you think, if I should keep my hair black or if I should let the brown go through and then put blonde on top of that. So let me know what you guys think, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.